Today I will tell you about keratoconus. Keratoconus is defined as non-inflammatory disease. In which there is progressive central or paracentral stromal thinning. Now, the cornea has 5 layers and the middle layer is stroma, which accounts 90% of the corneal thickness. So in keratoconus, this layer becomes thin, that is the thickness of cornea is decreased, and the number two is that cornea bulges out. It means that if this is the normal cornea, in keratoconus it comes outside like this. So the shape of the cornea is changed, and this results in a progressive myopia. And due to continuous change in the shape, it causes irregular astigmatism. We can also grade keratoconus into three different categories. Number one is mild, number two is moderate, number three is severe. This classification is on the base of keratometric readings. In mild, the corneal power is less than 48 diopters. Normally the power of cornea is 43 diopter. So less than 48 diopters means there is mild keratoconus. In moderate keratoconus, the corneal power is between 48 diopters to 54 diopters. And in severe, the corneal power is more than 54 diopters. The patient presents with the unilateral decreased in visual acuity, and occasionally patient may present with acute eye drops. In acute eye drops, the decimate membrane, another layer of the cornea, breaks down. As a result, the aqueous humor enters the cornea and make cornea opaque by causing corneal edema. In this case, acute eye drops, the patient reports photophobia, pain, and decreased visual acuity. Now I will tell you about the signs of keratoconus. There are a number of signs that help in diagnosing keratoconus. Number one is oil droplet sign. Oil droplet sign is seen during direct ophthalmoscopy at a distance of 50 cm. You will see a oil droplet reflex. Number two is seizuring reflex. It is seen during retinoscopy. Number three is Vogue's try. Vogue's try are deep vertical stroma lines that are seen during slit lamp examination. And number four, Munson sign. Munson sign is defined as bulging of lower eyelids during down gaze. Flesher ring. This ring appears better during cobalt blue filter. These are epithelial iron deposits. Acute eye drops, as I have explained before. Keratometry shows steep cornea. And nowadays, computerized corneal topography is used to diagnose and monitor keratoconus. So these are all the signs of the keratoconus that help you in diagnosing keratoconus. For treatment, number one is avoid eye rubbing. Number two is spectacles or soft contact lenses. These are only applicable in mild keratoconus. Number three is rigid gas permeable lenses. Number four, CXL, or also known as corneal cross linking. Number five is intracorneal ring segment implantation. And number six is keratoplasty. These are the surgical procedures, and these are the non-surgical procedures for the treatment of keratoconus.